And Mac Bennett, senior vice president of Third Way, former White House deputy assistant, and Sandy Hook Promise gun policy advisor. And my friend Brett Stevens, op-ed columnist for the New York Times and an MSNBC contributor. Matt, your reaction to the president's defense on guns, we should talk about them more. Well, and how about those knives?
I mean, making Piers Morgan sound like Edward R. Murrow is hard to do, but he did. That is a classic Trump response. It was like, you know, we need to rake the forest after the forest fires in California. He has no idea what he's talking about. When we've had mass shootings where there have been armed police officers, like at Columbine, they are unable to stop these massacres. It has nothing to do with arming the public. It has everything to do with the fact that it is incredibly easy in the United States for criminals and terrorists and others to get their hands on guns because we have these gaping loopholes in our law. He just doesn't want to do anything about it.
You know, a perfect example, most people didn't hear about this, but about a week before the massacre in Virginia Beach, a crazy person walked into a school in Japan and killed two people, including an 11-year-old school children. What's the big difference? That crazy person walked in with a knife because Japan has very strict gun laws. Guns are not banned in Japan. You can get access to them, but it's hard to get access. There's an extensive licensing requirements. So the difference is, both in Europe as well as in countries like Japan, there are crazy people who do terrible things, but their means to inflict mass casualty damage, like 58 dead and more than 800 injured and wounded in Vegas, is extremely limited. It doesn't happen in these countries.
It's not hard to get access here. Ralph Northam wants to do a lot. But given that he's got a Republican-led legislature in his state, does he have any chance?
You know, the only time we seem to make progress on guns at the state or federal level is when Democrats control all levers of power, both houses of the legislature plus the executive. That's when we've passed federal gun laws in 1968 and in 1993 and 94. We really haven't done much since then. So to your question, probably it's going to be tough. But the Virginia legislature, both the House and the Senate, hang by a thread. I think it's a two vote margin in both houses. And we in Virginia have an election coming up this year, and gun politics have shifted in the United States and in Virginia, and this is going to hurt Republicans if they're obstructionists.
They've gone front and center. Let's stay.